Okay.
All right. Well, first, I want to thank you all for taking the time out of your Friday night to be here, whether you're connected to a student or you're just here for a good time or whatever the reason is. I'm happy you're here. All of these students have put in a lot of really hard work. And for a lot of them, it's their first experience in a large ensemble and let alone a cello choir. Cello choirs are just so much fun. We're gonna play some pieces that might be familiar to some of you already, but that will be like arrangements that will throw in twists a little bit, which will be a good time. I'm really excited for this recital. It's the first big group ensemble recital type thing we've done, and I hope to do one at least once a year. But we'll see. So I'm gonna start with just an opening prayer, just get that out of the way, and then we'll take off. Our kind and gracious Heavenly Father, for this wonderful day and for the opportunity we have to be here together to share our talents, and we are grateful for all the work that the students have put in to be able to put on this performance for us, and we ask that you bless them, to be able to remain calm and be able to showcase the abilities they've been working so diligently to develop. And we say these things in the name of our Son Jesus Christ. Amen. Okay, I'm gonna get over there. So I did not make a program for this one, because I'm a slacker. But I will announce each piece before we play it. Alright, so to start, we'll be playing French folk song. There's not really a known composer, it's just the full piece. Some of you might know this if your student has already done book one, or if they're in book one, your siblings might hate it. But this is a different version of it. Thank you. is called Rigadoon, written by Henry Purcell. He is a really, really old composer. If I'm not mistaken, he's like before Bach, so a lot of the rules and stuff that we're used to as far as music just hadn't been established quite as well yet, but he was one of the really influential composers of his time. Okay.
Thank you.
next piece is a piece that I discovered this year, actually, thanks to a student who unfortunately couldn't make it today. But it's a piece called 100 Pipers. I actually don't know exactly where it comes from, but it has, I don't know if it's Irish or Scottish, and if you are related to that or connected to that culture, you'll know that you don't want to mess with that. But it's got a really fun like bagpipe feel at the beginning in our lower section, and then there's a really fun like kind of dance like melody that goes on top of it. It involves new technique that a lot of students haven't done yet called thumb position, where instead of playing in a normal position, they're up using their thumb as actually a finger to play, which is a really fun time, but also lots of headaches can come from. I'm really excited for some of my students to be able to try that for the first time, and then the other part isn't exactly easy as far as rhythms go. So I hope you enjoy. Part is fun, and it kind of gives opportunities to all levels, which is really nice. from anywhere from book one up to your more advanced students. So yeah, this is Zanny Boy. We got one more. I lied. We were gonna skip one. So actually, this piece is longer. But actually, we just have this is in the end of book three, so this is the graduation piece for that. We were almost gonna skip it, but I will be playing an accompaniment piece or accompaniment part, and then Logan and Joaquin are gonna be playing the written.
Thank you.
It's one thing to play, and it's another thing to have to listen to other parts around you, make sure your part fits in, right, rather than someone else following you. And this is just, it's such a big step, and I couldn't be prouder. Thank you.